brother, there's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, sister, know the water's sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do.
Oregon Trail Off-Road is more than just a team preparing for an expedition. It's a chance for us to attain an opportunity few have. It's a way for us to connect with the past, and most of all, it's a path to create new bonds and inspire a sense of adventure in you. It's been a little over a year now, and we have gained and lost members. We have changed vehicles and the way we operate, but at the heart of Oregon Trail, the purpose is still the same: to experience the road less traveled, to be stewards of the trail and ambassadors of adventure. It's experience and practice that hones our ability to adapt on the trail. And this trip gave us all sorts of opportunity to put thought into action. Just over the California border in the back hills of the Cascade Mountain Range, Jason and Cauxby lead a day excursion to the backside of Mount Ashland.
We're going out for a day trip up to Dutchman Peak, and then heading out back way to the backside of Mount Ashland and see how far we can make it. Where to start? They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me.
As the snow on the trail grew deeper, the group stopped just below Dutchman Peak to air down the tires for better traction.
What's up, guys? OTO. Trip to Mount Ashland in the snow with some sister truckers of ours, overlanding. We're just airing down. Snow's getting pretty gnarly.
This morning, a rainbow filled the sky. Yes, I woke up this morning, a rainbow filled the sky. Well, that was God telling me everything.
With tires aired down and legs stretched, we mounted our wagons and headed east towards our destination.
We're so long, old friend. When will we meet again? I said, so long, old friend. When will we meet again? Well, I don't know.
It wasn't long until we hit one of many firsts we've had with Oregon Trail Off-Road, a traffic jam in the back roads of the Cascade Mountain Range. A group went ahead of us and they had a Jeep and it looks like they blew the motor. So we pulled over to the side to let them by. They're kind of figuring out where they're going. Meanwhile, since they blew that Jeep up, we decided we're gonna put chains on the vehicles that we have chains. That way when we cut through, it will be a little easier on the vehicles.
Sad sight, Jeep pulled out by the Toyota.
Well, we're facing 2 feet of snow or so. So Jay is carving through. We've done this for about 50 yards. Came where the trail ended and started plowing our own. 'Cause I felt so far.
that struck an angel fell. Skies went dark and it all comes down. Jesus made the lies forgotten.
We got five guys, six guys in this beast. Yay!
After spinning our wheels for a while, a couple of guys from a local off-road shop slid in behind us. After a quick introduction, our new friends Matt and Cameron took a shot at laying tracks in the snow. It wasn't long until we realized we needed another strategy.
We need a land anchor.
We'll use one of Ian's fuel tank, bury it, put a big old wall behind it.
Let's do it.
Winch off of it.
The group came up with an idea for a land anchor. We emptied a fuel can, secured a strap around it, and buried it behind a berm 3 feet under the snow. With any luck, this will provide an anchor point to winch from.
I am lost for words. The cost for her was way too much to bear. You're not perfect.
So, we couldn't get any further. We had a couple guys, Cameron and Matt, and their families, and they came out here with their Toyotas, and we tried to cut trail to get to where we needed to be, but it didn't quite work out. We got a little ways, but it was slow going, so everybody decided to turn around. That's about where we got.
Well, I'm stuck. I'm very stuck. We went to get out to go back up, and I was really close to the edge, and it started sliding over. So we're currently stuck, waiting for some more trucks to come up the hill.
That's pretty good, Jason.
What's that? Getting stuck? Yeah. I thought if I did it, I might as well get myself as close to the edge as possible.
Can you go up any further, Ian?
I try.
The track's under you right now. You should try to go forward.
Okay.
We got your tires dug out.
Okay.
So, turn your wheel that way.
No,
roll back and then go back and then get a roll.
Hold on, I'm gonna get a track.
Okay, roll back.
Okay.
Good. Toes. Hold on. Here.
That track is loving.
Okay, so go up and try to get in the tracks, and then so go up to Ian's bumper. Yep,
here we go. We're in.
Jason's getting all kinds of stuck today. Woo!
There's something wrong.
Yeah, something is wrong. The front diff isn't engaged.
Damn.
So I'm in Jason's rig right now, driving his
up?
Because we're having problems
is
with it.
It's
don't know if we have a driver's side left front axle broken or what, but we got a clanking noise in the front, and we're having some real trouble with the four-wheel drive engaging and making noise. So we're just trying to get down this hill, and it is so slick right now. Like, it's so slick. I'm just trying to keep it on the road.
After limping the Land Cruiser home, we decided to call it a day. The next morning, we broke down the driver's side knuckle to see what the issue was. All right, so yesterday we were out in the snow, and we were getting a little crazy, cutting some trail, trying to get through the pass there, trying to get to the cutover. And I think in doing that, we were a little bit too rough on it, and we blew out the bearing on our axle. So basically, if you see over here, here's the bearing. You can see some of the metal flakes here, and this axle joint here is actually supposed to be connected to the axle right here. So that's all blown out, so we decided to go ahead and replace both the axles, do a chromoly axle so we don't have this issue again.
and yeah, hopefully that takes care of the problem.
After a week delay in waiting for parts, we installed our RCV chromoly axles and headed home from our extended vacation a little stronger than we were before.
This trip and the obstacles it held gave us a small taste of what we were to face on our next practice exped as we plot our overland route through the Western Cascade mountain range. The problems on the practice trips we take gives the team the opportunity to work together and prepares us for our 40-day journey down the Oregon Trail.
So I packed my things and